Yo, what's up, my brother? What's up, my sister? This is your boy Oscar Ntege again with yet another amazing video. In this particular video today, guys, I'm going to show you how to do high-end retouching on a full body picture. Yes, it's not a full body up to the feet, but something that has a lot of skin to show off. When I was starting out, I struggled with editing images that exposed a lot of skin, whereby I found it hard to match the skin tone colors. But in this video, I'm going to show you how we are going to do that. I'm going to use the dynamic actions pack for all this particular retouching. Basically, it is going to be retouching done on autopilot. Ready? Let's dive into this. And then what we're going to do, we are first going to come here into Windows and then come into our actions here. And then we're going to look for the dynamic action pack. If you want that dynamic actions pack, click the link in the description below and get it, by the way, then and just download it so that you can install it in your Photoshop and use it on your next project. Since this picture was taken with a 60, we're going to use the dynamic beauty actions pack definitely. If you want to get a copy of the dynamic beauty action pack, click the link in the description below and download it for yourself and follow along. So we're going to come here and get the beauty frequency just right there, and then we play just like that. So what we're going to do, we're just going to come and blur this just a little until we see that the skin is smooth, you know, until we see that the whole texture is gone. And the next thing we're going to do, we're going to come here and say okay. After doing that, we're just going to come into the layer panel here, just right here, and then choose the background copy right there, and then we say okay. So here we have it. Now the pictures, the frequencies of the pictures have been separated, so we have all of them at a different kind of layers. So the next thing we're going to do, we are now going to match skin tones. We're just going to first match skin tones, then after come work on the general skin texture. So how are we going to do that? Before we go there, let us first rename this as tones, and we're going to rename this as textures. So in order for us to match skin tones, you're going to just come and have this tonal layer selected, and then you create a new layer slightly above it. We are going to name this blotches, you know, to represent the blotches. So why do I do this first? Because I want to first do the initial panel beating before I go into the general retouch. Because if you go ahead and begin retouching, when you apply frequency separations on areas like these, you may end up having a very flat image, or you may end up overdoing the image. So it is this initial panel beating that really makes the whole image look more natural and less edited. So what we do, we just come and get to this layer. We get our brush tool right here, and then we get the blending mode and turn it to lighten. Yes. So what you're going to do, we just come zoom this in, and then with the brush tool selected, of course it has to be soft, we're going to come and reduce the flow to around 5, just around there. And then we're going to come here and click the color picker. You just press alt on your keyboard, you pick a color around there, and then you just come and paint over here. You don't want to, so because this one just gives us at least a starting point. Let me show you. Of course you build it slowly by slowly. See how it changes like that? So you first come and work on these blotches. You could come on, you go on actually picking colors from around that particular area and filling in, you know, all these shadows, because you don't want to really come and just kill the textures completely. So we're going to come and get also some of these skin colors in the tonal area and just come and slightly paint over around that area, you know. So what we are doing, we are getting rid of, you know, Now, this we can, of course, remove. I'll just create a layer mask next to it. It is the same where we come and still come and match the knuckles here just by painting all over here. Right there. Still. So let's zoom out. So let us look at this. Look at that. That's the before. That's the after. That's the before. That's the after. So it is this initial panel beating that helps us get a very super awesome image. So I'm going to just come and do a little bit of cleaning up. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to create a layer mask just right next to this particular layer, the blotches layer. Just click by clicking over here. And then I'll just come with a brush and then turn the blending mode back to normal and just come and paint over where I don't want. I'll just come and bring this back to 100. So I'll just come and just paint over here where I didn't want the paint really to go all through. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to come and merge down. I just come and after when I see it's perfect, I just come and merge this down so that it is part of this bottom layer. So now when you look at it, we don't have that skin tone that was really so dark. So the next thing we're going to do, we're now going to work on the texture layer. So we're going to come here and then get our tool, spot healing tool, and then we press the alt key and then we begin cleaning. Because we don't want to overdo it really, so I'm just removing these simple spots. It's not a very big image, so I'll be fast in this on this one. So we come and eliminate all these spots. I think I remember we had some particular spot here. So I'll just clean that in the. Now such marks you usually leave them on. Now like this particular mark, you leave those ones on and get my spot healing tool. Then remove all that. Okay. So the next thing we're going to do right now, we're now going to work on the skin tones. We're going to work on the skin colors. We're going to have all these, see all these dark patches blended into the whole piece. So I just come with my lasso tool here. I put the feather at 18 since it's not a very big image, and then just come and select through like that. Filter, blur, you say Gaussian blur. Just like that. And don't take it overboard, because if you do it over, you take it overboard, the image will turn out to be flat and you don't want the image to be really flat. So I press Command Alt F or Command Option and F if you're using a Mac. If you're using PC, it is Control Alt F to repeat the similar action like that. So we're not going to do it to take it overboard, because we really need to maintain her skin texture. You need to maintain, you know, those beautiful body forms and the like. Of course, I go into details into this whole retouching process in the Retouching Secrets Masterclass. If you want to enroll and become a super great retoucher by next Friday, of course, just go and join right now. Click the link in, actually, it's the first link in the description below. And just join so that you get a full glimpse into the whole retouching process. You know, these are just bits and, you know, filter, blur, you come into Gaussian blur, and then we come and just because it is a full week masterclass where we go through all these. By next Friday, I'm sure you would be a super awesome retoucher after you enroll into the course. It is something that is going to really, really, really take your photography to the next level. If you're serious about taking the photography to the next level and making serious money with your photography, enroll for the Retouching Secrets Masterclass. And by the way, right now it's on offer. It is not on its normal price of the $297. Right now it's at only $57 for you to get access. You can, I don't know whether by the time you're watching this video the promotion is still on, but go there and check and see. Yeah, so you come and just work on all these, and then yeah, so we're going to leave the water droplets on now. We don't want to have the water droplets ready, you know. So there you have it. The next thing we are going to do right now, now we are going to do some burning and dodging. So how we do that, you still come and click onto the burn and dodging layer, this one here, the burn and dodging action, and then you just play the action just like that. So you're going to get these layers, of course, and then which we are going to come and just burn in. I go into details of burning and dodging still into the Retouching Secrets Masterclass, where I take you through everything on where it will burn and all that stuff. There is even an automated action of burning and dodge, but here I'm just taking you through how the whole process is. So you still come and I don't want the video to be so long, so you come and just paint over. Like that. All we want is just to have, I don't want to overdo it. I just want because the lighting already gives us I won't go really into serious burning and dodging, but you get the point. It's about just creating a bit of dimension and depth into the whole image. I'll still come here and get into the cleavage area, and then burn. And I contour the whole body so that I create a bit of depth and dimension. Same applies here. You need to feel like when somebody looks at the image, they should feel like they can go all around it, and that is why we do all this burning and dodging. So I'll just come onto the dodge layer and do the same. So I'll just emphasize the highlights by still using the brush, just like this. Remember, you're using a brush and just playing with the layer masks, just like that. Till you come here and then you dodge and you get her chiseled as can be. So let us just look at the before and after and see what we have. That's the before, that's the after. Before and after, see how we've emphasized the cleavage area, how we've made the hands more round. I think we're going to do the same thing at around the thigh area. I'm going to come still with our brush, and then we just highlight that part of the thigh so that her hip bulges like that. So what are we going to do next? The next thing we're going to do right now, we're going to do what we call a color grading. Definitely that is what we're going to do. So we're going to, there are many actions we can use here. Now there is also, there is this glamour colors. Let us try the glamour colors and see what it gives us. Ooh, wow, that's very beautiful. Now you're going to get all these actions actually in when you enroll for the Retouching Secrets Masterclass, actually, you'll even get more of such presets, because this is not the full package. I'm giving you basically the few things, but in the Retouching Secrets Masterclass, you get all this for free. So you come and adjust accordingly. So I'll just come, of course, here into the curves adjustment layer and pull the mid tones just a little bit down so that I get it to pop a little bit even more. Just want the blacks to be not so dark. Now you see what is happening, this particular artifact. Now this is why you're supposed to shoot raw and maybe shooting at what they call 16-bit. When you don't shoot at 16-bit or you use a camera which has a low bit rate, this is what happens. You get, when you apply colors, the colors get this particular kind of destruction. This is what you're looking at here, this artifacting, this kind of artifacts here. That is why it is advisable you shoot at the biggest bit rate of your camera. Even when you're processing camera raw, you process them in bit rates that are above 32, in that when you apply any effects, they don't crash the pixels. Now here, the curves adjustment layer, actually not even just the curves adjustment layer, I think it's the vibrancy, that is, when you put the effects, they tend to, see what happens, they tend to create artifacts, they tend to destroy the whole image. So you don't want to go into that kind of thing. So what do we do with this? I just come and create a stamp on top of this. Now when you look at these particular artifacts, it's there like noise. So I'll just come here into filter and say camera raw filter. Yeah, camera raw filter. And then I'll just come into the detail panel, where into the detail panel, and then I'll just come and say color noise, like that. Let me just zoom in and you see, when look at this, that is how it's been with purples and the like. But when I come and remove color noise, definitely it goes. All I have now, it is just an image, a bikini that looks wet on that particular kind of vibe. So you get the whole point. Now that's that for today about how to edit full images. I'll see you in the next tutorial. If you've really enjoyed this video, come on, give me a hit the subscribe button. Of course, leave your comment there and tell me what exactly has resonated with you. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel, because it helps the channel really grow. Don't forget to take the dynamic actions pack for your practice. I'll see you in the next video, and adios. I love you so much.